But missing two weeks during preseason camp, how big a factor might that play for her, especially early?
It's huge, and not just because she's a freshman, but also because she's a freshman point guard. As the point guard, you have to kind of know everything that's going on. You have to learn the system, have to know what decisions need to be made, and also have to get on the same page as your head coach with Tina March, because you're kind of that coach on the floor. So for Abby Gonzalez to have missed that time, it's really, you know, it hurts her, but she'll get back. She's such a great player. She's one of those cerebral players that really understands the game of basketball. I'm very excited to see her get out there and watch her play defense and really bust this team once she gets in the mix.
The cheerleaders are giving off on this point as they are settling out for about five minutes now. We're holding pattern. It's time to finish the shot clock. We talked about Delaware fresh guard, George Wilson with his fresh point guard.
A lot of experience playing with that shot clock. You worked it, practiced with it above the basket. How might that change things where you're trying to find it on the fly out there?
Yeah, and I think it becomes a habit. So you do start to get used to it in practice. Like you said, then if they're going to have to stick one on the floor or somewhere else, it can throw you off. But you know what? You just got to go with it. You got to go with the flow. You got to say, okay, it's going to be there on the floor or whatever it may be. But that, I think, is a big adjustment for a freshman point guard, because a lot of these high schools don't even have shot clocks. And if they do, they're not as used to, High school basketball is a lot quicker as far as they get the shots up a lot quicker, where college basketball, the game itself, plays at a faster pace, but they take more time in the half-court set. So as these two freshman point guards go at it a little bit, it's kind of learning to look over to your coach, to know when to look over, to know when to just go, and then also to know when to glance at that shot clock and pull it out. And if there's, if they do like a two-man game or a final 10-second or 5-second kind of set, to know when that's going to occur.
Just feel bad right now for Alicia Walker and Joe Shirley and their staff. Everything was working as smoothly as it could be. And then literally, as the teams are on the floor, they are scrambling, so the holding pattern is exactly what we've been talking about this season. I don't know if people want to hear us talk about this. They're probably saying, hey, let's get going so we don't have to listen to them talk gibberish. The voice of the holdout, the team, the band, now the voice of the crowd. So now it's back to drawing things up and working on strategy. But one more thing to be said, it's the opener, especially for Delaware to talk all season long about what they want to do, what they want to try to achieve. And now you get to this stage, you got to get a little more.
Well, I guess on the positive side, Tina Martin is able now to go over those points of emphasis and has the players' attention. So, in a sense, I kind of get a sense of the timeout before the game starts.
We are in an extensive timeout right now. They are continuing to work on the shot clock. It looks like maybe a secondary shot clock is what we might have to go to at this point. And if you're Delaware and you've got the scouting report down, you've got all the practice, you've got all the energy. So a little bit of a disadvantage right now, they're not going to the center, right?
I was wondering if they might let the players come back out and start warming up again because this is a long delay. Even if they let them get layoff lines or something, having them come out flat, I would think they might let them warm up again. Officials just want to know, coach staff talked to them about land, and I think George Jason, coach staff, is asking them to want to warm up here. I think that's the right thing to do. I mean, this is now about seven minutes away.
This is almost half of the halftime right now, so you definitely should get back out.
Even just if they cheat shoot a layup or two, just to get those juices flowing again.
Delaware now in the mid-court circle. standing there. They don't walk over to the other basket. That is what they're going to do. They shoot around a little bit. And maybe they're not. That looked like the plan was. Well, one of them can't get held up. Now the other official overrules it. So they will go over and get that.
All right, here we are, ready to go from the Bob Carpenter Center. Delaware moving left to right here in this opening quarter, and George Mason wins the tip, backing it to the freshman, Sarah Kaminsky, who brings it across the timeline, dribbling between the circles, angling right wing for Mason, lobbing it to far corner right, right at it, pawed at by Anabosi, but got handled back. Finding Padgett top of the circle, lobbing it back line, but it's tipped away. Makeda Nicholas swooping in to knock it to the baseline. Stays with Mason, 13 to shoot.
And that's great rotation by Makeda Nicholas.
So the inbound will come baseline left here for George Mason. Kaminsky will trigger. Mason player fell down away from the ball, but everything moves forward. They lob it left block to Padgett. She splits a double, lays it home with the left hand. Mason on the board first, 2-0.
And Makeda Nicholas just a split second too slow on that rotation on the back left side.
Gianieri Bell fell down hard, but no call, and Delaware ends up giving up a layup. Here's the Hens the other direction. Cargo with it, top of the circle, right wing feed to Nicholas. Lobbing it near corner, giving it to Chapman. Inside of the right block, Anabosi. Turn and face, head fake, left hand, fade away, layup too strong, off the window. Brown swooped in, grab the rebound. 15-footer from the foul line, front rim off the mark. And a long rebound corralled by Padgett for George Mason.
Nicole Anabosi just taking a little too long to make that decision once she faced up on the basket.
It comes George Mason the other direction. Padgett trailing the play. Straightaway three is good over Anabosi. And it's 5-0 George Mason to start the game.
And in these early couple possessions already, Delaware just seems a split second too slow. They're getting to the spot, but just a tad late.
Here's Cargo bringing it across the timeline. A little tentatively as she looks back at her head coach. Bounce pass between the circles to Brown. Brown dribbling right wing, picks up her bounce, feeds corner to Nicholas, lobs it right block to Chapman, turn and face, one dribble, picks it up, looks opposite wing, open three, Cargo hits. Barely Cargo, her first three on her first shot, and ends back to within two.
How's that as a way to start a career? And they got to look for her, a lot of fake one way, and get the ball to Bailey Cargo. She's a knockdown shooter.
Mentioned it earlier, one of the best in the state of North Carolina in high school. Here's a lob on the right block. It's Bell trying to go to work. Nice move as she drew contact. Chapman and Anabosi were both in the vicinity. And they give the foul to Shade Chapman. It'll be her first, team's first. 8-10 left, opening quarter. And Hens down 5-3.
You know, I've had an opportunity to watch Bailey Cargo in practice, and I just really like what I saw as far as footwork, her just her attitude. She looks like she's been there before, and she's that knockdown shooter, but she can put it on the floor. Nice 1-2 step from, you know, with the ball in either hand and knock down that shot. Little curious, though, that she's actually been bringing the ball up, and Erica Brown's been playing the two in these first few possessions.
Bell hits her first free throw. She'll get one more. Chapman takes her seat. Hannah Jardine enters for the first time. Tana Martin talked about wanting to move Erica Brown to the two. Certainly the plan was for Abby Gonzalez to start at point, but her injury in offseason camp really hurt that a little bit. She's fallen a bit behind. Second free throw good. 7-3. George Mason leads. And here's Cargo across the timeline, dribbling right wing against the zone for Mason. Cross-court feed to Brown. Brown dribbles far corner. Left elbow feed goes to Anabosi. She had it knocked away and stolen by Bell. Brown tried to steal it back. Nice spin move, though, by Bell to avoid her. Feeds it far corner to a wide-open Bolton. Bolton gets it right wing to Kaminsky, lobbing it inside. Nice catch by Bell and can't bank it home. In and out off the rim, rebound Anabosi for Delaware.
Love the way Bailey Cargo also just came to that basketball. As soon as she saw the rebound, she was way back in the half court and came back to the ball. Little things that some of these freshmen are doing well.
Jardine up top for Delaware, feeding to Cargo, top of the circle. Cargo dribbling left wing for the Hens. Bounce pass out near center court to Brown. Brown with seven to shoot. Turn and face. Dribble towards the right wing. Shake and bake move towards the lane. Out to Jardine. Spinning off balance runner. Good off the window. What a shot by Hannah Jardine.
That was a great desperation toss by Hannah. And the way she angled that to go high off the glass. Really nice job by the senior.
Spinning away from the defense. Playing with confidence against the Mason team. She dropped 31 on a year ago. So the Hens to within two, 6:51 left to go in the opening quarter. Kaminsky, far wing feed over to Padgett. Padgett dribbling towards the corner, got Nicholas up in the air, but airballed the shot. Nice rebound by Bolton over Jardine, though. Rebound batted on the putback that wouldn't go, and it's out of bounds off the hands of Mason. Bolton did good work to get the ball, but couldn't finish from point blank, and Delaware takes it back.
Yeah, and Delaware doing a nice job getting into position on the box outs, but they're just not able to grab the ball right now. A lot of tips, but again, that's expected in the first game of the season. They need to go up, get it. Be strong with two hands, keep the ball low, and get your elbows out.
First sub for George Mason, and it's a big one. Bridget O'Donnell, 6'6", into the game as Janieri Bell takes a seat for the Patriots. Here's Brown in the forecourt, near corner to Anabosi, back to Brown, right wing. Up top, the Cargo. Cargo left wing to Jardine. Back to Cargo. They have a catch into the corner now to Nicholas driving baseline. Got to the rim. Got her shot blocked from behind. And a rebound grabbed by Sylvia Maxwell, who also checked in at the last whistle.
McKenna Nicholas needs to square up after she drives on that baseline.
The big O'Donnell with it near corner. Lobs it top of the circle to Padgett. Padgett hands it off to Kaminsky. Two point guards in there right now for Mason. She gives it to the other point guard, Maxwell, foul line right. Up top, the lob feed goes to O'Donnell. Swings it left wing to right, right into the corner. Kaminsky for three. Back rim, no. And nobody got the rebound for Delaware. Ends up in the hands of a hustling Padgett. She finds Kaminsky short with a left wing three. Nikita Nicholas the rebound. Outlets it forward to Brown. Brown trying to drive all the way out of control. Runner is good. What touch from Erica Brown.
How long have we seen that year after year? And she just has that little floater. Sometimes she'll take that jump stop, but then she'll go up high with the floater, and that's what we saw there.
Set out of control because I thought she was going to crash into the defense, but did a great job to avoid the defender and floated in. So we're tied at 7, 5:18 to go in this opening quarter. Here's a back down move from O'Donnell on the right block. She got it knocked free, and a foul on George Mason going for loose ball. Sylvia Maxwell called for personal. That'll be her first, team second.
Yeah, I love the movement of Delaware right now. They're getting to the spots that they need to get to. In the first couple possessions, we said they were a tad late. Seems like they're starting to recover a little bit better. But I do like the movement of Delaware. They're doing a good job boxing out. They just either have to grab the ball or make sure they're getting a body on somebody.
Hens and George Mason tied at 7. Season opener for Delaware. Cargo with it right wing for the Hens. Top of the circle feed to Anna Bosey. Dribbles inside the arc. Picks up her bounce. Left wing lob to Jardine. Bounce pass far corner goes to Chapman, who just checked in. Makeda Nicholas sitting down. Chapman cross-court feed near corner to Brown. Brown right wing to Cargo. Cargo left-hand bounce working towards the foul line. Four to shoot, hands it to Brown. Two to shoot to the top of the key inside the arc, and she walked as she switched pivot feet trying to get the angle for the shot. That'll take us to a timeout on the floor. 4:44 left to go in the opening quarter. Delaware and George Mason tied at 7 on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
basketball when they box out, go get those rebounds, not just push back, but go get the ball.
Delaware debut of Abby Gonzalez in for the first time for the Hens as Bailey Cargo takes a seat. Mason with the ball, moving right to left. Wright, who's been quiet in the early going, feeds it near wing to a teammate. Inside it goes to Bell. Bell walked as she tried to spin. It was a good feed from true freshman Alexis Great, who just checked in. But then awkward footwork from the sophomore Bell.
You know, you think of these freshmen, Bailey Cargo and Abby Gonzalez coming in. There's so much to think about as a guard in the defensive system and in the offensive system. So a lot that they have to work through in these first few games.
Gonzalez more of a true point guard, 5'7", out of Wexford, Pennsylvania. They get a far corner to Chapman. Chapman feeding top of the key to Gonzalez. Gonzalez with the pass inside to Anabosi. She was shoved in the back. That's why she bobbled it. And the foul goes against Mason, so Delaware maintains possession.
And even just that vision that Abby Gonzalez has right away, you even saw it right away. She's already dishing it in on the shape up. So she just has the vision and the cerebral, you know, mentality of a point guard.
How about the speed of that decision, too?
Well, exactly. And it's almost like a tip pass because she knows what she's going to do with the basketball before she gets it.
She lobs the inbound out near center court to Hannah Jardine, who hands it to Erica Brown. 4 minutes left in the opening quarter. Delaware and George Mason tied at 7. Near wing feed to Chapman, hands it off there to Gonzalez. Swing it around the perimeter, left wing to Jardine, back to Brown. To Jardine, foul line left, elbow to Anabosi, looking opposite wing, and a three is good. They'll call it a deep two. Abby Gonzalez, toe on the line, but Delaware's up 9-7.
How about these freshmen? Abby Gonzalez, Bailey Cargo hitting their first shots as Delaware Blue Hens.
And off of really good ball movement from the Hens, making the extra pass and being rewarded for it. Some three-quarter court pressure by Delaware by some time. Here's Mason attacking the other direction, into the lane off the bounce. It's great, and she was bumped on her way to the 10. And that's a foul on Gonzalez. It'll be her first, team second.
And I love the way both Abby Gonzalez and Bailey Crow are stepping into their shots. They come to the basketball, good footwork, and there you see the foul on Abby Gonzalez, but just in the rotation going back. So when you get stuck a little bit low, you got to go at the right angle.
Well, the inbound will come from Great Ear. Baseline right, feeds it opposite corner, open triple for right. Right couldn't get it to go. Good box out by the freshman Gonzalez, who grabs the rebound. Spins her way and works it across the timeline, angling near the Mason bench. Bounce pass goes top of the key to Brown. Brown, awkward pass to Jardine. Nice job to come get it from Hannah to avoid the turnover. Up top to Chapman, 18-foot straightaway jumper in and out. Good box out from Padgett, causes an over-the-back foul on Anabosi.
And that's a shot Shade Chapman has hit in the past. You know, she kind of has a green light for that foul line jump shot. I think they want her to look to go to the basket a little bit more or look for the high-low there, but she can take that shot and make it.
And that foul on Anabosi, that's something that really plagued her a season ago.
Yeah, and they really can't afford to have her in foul trouble. There's a little bit of a better rotation down low, but they need her in the basketball game.
Her first, but she takes a seat. Here's a three the other way from George Mason. A little strong from J.C. Bolton, but a long rebound chased down by Wright. Back to Bolton, right wing, driving on Jardine. Spins it out to Wright. Right wing triple is good. Her first basket, and George Mason's up a point, 10-9.
And that's just a scenario where the defense broke down. Erica Brown got kind of plowed over, and everybody had to over-rotate there.
Here's Gonzalez, entry feed, right block, Nicholas, fadeaway, turnaround, jumper wouldn't go, but she got bumped on the elbow by Padgett, and Makayna Nicholas earns herself a trip to the line to shoot a pair.
And you'll see, you know, Makayna Nicholas has that ability to shoot outside, even to the three-point line, so she likes to shoot the ball, but I think, you know, this staff also wants to see her maybe give the shot fake, put the ball on the ground and go to the basket, but fortunate with that fadeaway, she was able to get fouled.
69% a season ago, hits the first, she'll get one more. Another substitution for Mason going deep to the bench. In the early going, Taylor Dotson checks in. Dotson did not play in the opener against Radford. She replaces Padgett, who takes a seat. Second free throw good for Nicholas, and the Hens back up by one, 11-10.
Yeah, and you know, if you're Tina Martin, you have to be pleased at least with these first few minutes, this first quarter for this young team. You know, really showing some grit, showing some identity here.
Especially considering it's their opener. Mason's got a game under their belt. Casey Davison for the first time as well. Cross-court feed, far corner. Great three, wouldn't go. Nice offensive board by Wright. Her follow, a teardrop that falls through. And Mason's up one as you see all back and forth. Final 2 minutes of the opening quarter.
And sometimes some of the hardest things in this zone, in this matchup zone, is finding someone to lay a body on to box out.
Inbound, or entry feed, I should say, goes to Chapman. Great seal move. Right hand bank is good. Nice touch from Sade Chapman.
That's exactly what we were just talking about. A little show-and-go move there right to the hoop.
Here's Great the other way for Mason. Delaware back up by a point. Final 90 seconds of the opening quarter. Lob on the left block to Davis. Her shot rejected by Chapman. Gonzalez ends up with the ball. Weaving her way across the timeline. Angling to the right wing. Crossing over to the top of the key. She'll back things out. Good decision by the point guard to set it up.
Yeah, great patience there.
Feeds it left wing to Brown. Top of the key to Chapman. Lobbing left elbow to Nicholas. Double came and she was fouled. Reach in from Casey Bolton. And that'll be the fourth team foul against Mason. So for the final minute, 12, George Mason will be over the limit. As back into the game for Delaware, Abby Gonzalez. They'll try to buy a quick breather for Erica Brown.
How about this, Matt? You got two freshmen in your backcourt right now, Abby Gonzalez and Bailey Cargo. That's a lot. That's a lot of confidence that Tina Martin has. Both of your guards, freshmen.
The inbound will come from one of those freshmen. It's Cargo who gets it into the left block. Chapman fadeaway. Banker is good. Showing off the array of moves. Delaware up by three.
Yeah, Chapman really showing some growth here with taking her time and following through on those shots. She always had the moves, but sometimes didn't have the touch. This year she's showing she has that touch.
Boy, Delaware does look much more athletic on the defensive side so far. Kaminsky with it near wing. Cross-court feed to right. Right drives towards the lane, and a three-second violation caught against Mason gives it back to the hand.
You know, the identity of this team usually is, year after year, their defense. But you're right, there's a little pep here. I think they're able to make these rotations a little bit better, you know. And on offense, I think, you know, Nicholas, Chapman, and Anabosi are doing a fantastic job of really sealing off their players so those entry passes are there.
Asked Dana Martin before the game, where are you with the zone? And she said, well, we're far from there yet. But at this stage last season, as opposed to where we are this stage this season, a world of difference, much further along. Here's Jardine, far corner, 4-3, it's good. And Delaware has a game-high six-point lead.
And the reason why these shots are open on the outside is because they've been pounding it into the post, and now they can kick it back out.
18-12, two-second differential shot and game clock here in this opening quarter. Wilford Kelly, and for the first time for George Mason, got it on the right block, but a shot rejected. Nicholas tipped it away. Long rebound corralled by Delaware. On the run, it's Cargo finding Jardine. Jumper wouldn't go in transition. Rebound, Kelly. Kelly brings it up the other way. Feeds it forward to right. 3 seconds left. Right finds an open Kelly at the buzzer. Banks home the three. Oh, my, what a way to end the opening period for George Mason. A back-and-forth affair. And after one, it's Delaware 18, George Mason 15. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. top of the key, lobbing it inside to Nicholas, trying to back down to the defender, spinning right side, can't finish, a 10-foot fadeaway. Jardine, though, tipped the rebound to keep it alive, and Gonzalez swooped in to grab the loose ball for Delaware. Great hustle from both players, especially Hannah Jardine. Crossover move by Gonzalez, working to the left wing, getting in at the foul line. Chapman jumper wouldn't go. Long rebound, grabbed by Gonzalez. Her follow, front rim no good. This time the weak side rebound, Nicholas tipped it, but finally Bell grabbed it for George Mason.
Yeah, Delaware doing a good job, though, getting their hands on those basketballs.
Nice baseline move off the bounce from Maxwell. Fadeaway jumper, though, would not go. Rebound, hot potato to round, loose on the floor. Chapman picks it up for Delaware. Outlets it for DeCargo. On the run, across the timeline. Spacing the floor, near wing, feeding top of the circle, Gonzalez, beg your pardon. Left wing feed to Jardine, up top Nicholas, right back to Hannah. Feeding left block to Chapman, turnaround jumper, good. They gave her space, she knocks down the shot, and the Hens are back up five.
And I think that's the threat that you know, the post players have right now, because they've showed and goed and they put it on the floor. They're respecting that, but George Mason has to get a hand in and body up down there in the post.
Kelly, Aaron pass taken away by Chapman, and she jumped the pass lane. Here comes Delaware the other way. Gonzalez across the midcourt stripe. Towards the wing near side. Up top to Jardine. Entry feed. Right elbow. Nicholas lost her footing, lost the basketball. Taken away from her. Right the other direction. Stopping at the foul line. Good job by the freshman to stop the ball. Challenge the shot. It wouldn't go. Padgett the rebound, and her follow is good, though. And again, Mason back to within three.
Yeah, Delaware really has to get a body. They're ball watching right now when the ball goes up and they're not laying a body. You have to find someone and go attack.
Here's Gonzalez, entry feed, left elbow. It goes to Chapman, couple of dribbles. Opposite wing to Jardine, up top Nicholas. Swing it left wing, Gonzalez. Back to Nicholas, lobbing it inside, middle of the lane. Chapman jumper's good. Boy, is she looking confident on the offensive end.
The biggest difference I'm noticing in this first game is the ball movement on offense. It's not stagnant. They're really doing a good job of reversing the basketball inside, outside, and that's what's opening it up.
Pretty clean so far from Delaware. 22-17, Hens lead, 7:34 to go in the opening half. On the left wing, it's Padgett, fires up the triple, wouldn't go, box out. Jardine going to be called for the hold on Bell, was battling for position inside, and a little bit of an interlock on the box out try. And a Bosio return for Delaware. Erica Brown back in as well. Cargo takes a seat, as does Chapman for UD.
Yeah, it's definitely getting physical down low here on the defensive side for Delaware. Kind of getting tangled up, and I think some frustration from George Mason, but Delaware trying to get a body, but getting all tangled up.
Inbound, far corner, open three. Padgett couldn't get it. Long rebound again, Jardine hustling it down.
Good leadership there by Hannah Jardine, letting know to Addy Gonzalez that someone was right on her when she passed without basketball.
Being harassed by Great, beating top of the circle to Jardine, swinging it right wing to Brown. Brown looking inside for Nicholas, lobbing it to her on the block. Again, spinning, turnaround jumper. This one's good for the baseline, and the Hens are up a game high seven.
I really like the patience there by Erica Brown, allowing McKenna Nicholas to get her position and holding on the basketball, giving her a second, and then feeding it.
Kaminsky lobbing it far wing right with a basketball. Cross court feed taken away. Nicholas batted it into the front court. What a feed to save it into Brown, who lays it up and couldn't get it to go. And then an over the back foul on Nicholas. Oh, Erica Brown just got stuck a little too tight to the rim, but an incredible effort from Makeda Nicholas.
And what a play. Tiptoed the line, knew she had Erica Brown. Great angle and getting it to the center of the floor, and then Erica Brown scooping it up. Just couldn't finish there. I think she had a little bit of contact and expected the foul, but just couldn't kind of finish that off.
Here's a collegiate debut of Simone DeFries for Delaware. 5'11 out of Bergen Field, New Jersey. If the name sounds familiar, sister played at Northeastern and was quite the player over the last 4 years. She's in there on the defensive side. As Delaware in that matchup zone, they get it high post to Padgett. There's George Mason. She dribbles it off the leg of a defender, but Mason gets the loose ball. It's run down in the corner by Dotson. Cross court feed, left wing to right. They're all over her. Right off the bounce with two to shoot. Has to hoist front rim with a shot. Wouldn't go. Jardine crashing the glass, as does Gonzalez. Neither could corral it. It was Gonzalez, I beg your pardon, and ends up in Mason's hands.
Always tough when the shot clock's winding down and then you have to play another set on defense.
There's a far wing lob over to right, getting it top of the key to Kaminsky, 13 to shoot. Near wing to Crate. Crate trying to lob it inside, and a foul called against Delaware. It was DeFries who got sealed, got stuck on the back hip of the post, and that'll be the third team foul. And see if they got a sub. They initially called the foul on DeFreeze. They put Gonzalez's number up on the board, but I believe that foul was called on Simone DeFreeze.
I think it was. And looking at the replay, it definitely looked like it was. And Simone DeFreeze, just a lot of potential. Very athletic body. They're looking forward to her being here.
There's a long athletic body. Bolton with that high release over Chapman hits the three, and it's 24-20.
Yeah, Delaware really starting to slip in too low. They're getting stuck too low and not able to recover and close out on the three-point shot.
Mason hit five threes in their opener against Radford. They came from two players. Wright hit three of them, two from Tiffany Pageant. And here is a three-second call against the Hens. Anna Bosi lost control of the basketball and could not gather it back before staying too long in the lane.
And after she faced up and the help came on her right side, she has to be able to swing the ball into her left hand and put the ball on the ground with her left hand and go up. She went right into traffic instead of going to the left side.
Good help from Dotson, who came over with a double. Carrie Weston for the first time for Delaware. The athletic junior left-hander who can really fly, trying to make her presence felt defensively. But they find it open. Dotson, far corner, triple wouldn't go. Weak side rebound, Chapman for Delaware.
And this bench for Delaware already much deeper in game one than it was probably all of last year.
Brown's been quietly early going. Drives to the lane, kicks it out to West on the right wing. West tried to cross over in front of the defender, had it knocked free. And Abosi got it out to Brown. Open triple for him. No. Good box out. Rebound McCool for George Mason.
Great recognition there by Nicole and Abosi, though, to see Erica Brown and kick that ball out.
McCool, big 6'2 freshman. She can be physical on the inside, can only play for short bursts, but can make her presence felt when she's out there. Wright has it left wing, tried to lob high post. It was tipped away. Good hustle by Dotson to chase it down, but then called for the hook. As she tried to go baseline, the offensive foul will give it back to Delaware when we return. 4:30 left to go in the second quarter. It's the Hens 24, Georgia Mason 20. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WBOV.
now. They're getting out rebounded, 14-13, and giving up, too many offensive rebounds right now.
Yeah, a little bit of a concern considering they've missed 17 shots as George Mason. Delaware only 10, so you'd think the Hens would have a bigger rebounding advantage. Instead, they're minus. Here's Anna Bosey with it, left block for Delaware, feeding it opposite corner to Cargo. High post bounce pass goes to Chapman. One dribble, splits a double, banks it up. It wouldn't go, but she's fouled. And that's the shot of Chapman we were expecting last season. We saw in flashes the transfer from Clemson, who has an incredible array of offensive moves.
Yeah, her footwork has gotten much better, but it's really that finish. She has the tut, the move, but then it's the finish.
First free throw, front rim off the mark. Chapman will get one more. She struggled with free throws a season ago, only 56%, but that was a great split from Chapman.
Yeah, I really just love the patience of this team right now. They're really taking their time to get it into the post, allowing the post players to get position, and they're not immediately reversing it when they're playing their little triangle on the side.
Got to make free throws, though. She rattles out the second, so misses a pair. Lead stays at 4 for Delaware. 4 minutes left in the half. Across the timeline on the bounce, it's the true freshman, great. High post entry feed goes to Davis. Davis lobs it high-low, but missing was Bell, and the rebound grabbed by Makeda Nicholas. Outlets it to the freshman, weaving her way through the defense. It's Cargo, lobbing it top of the key to Nicholas, feeding it right elbow. Anna Bosey can't hit the 15-footer. Worked so hard on that shot in the offseason. Rebound Mason. Here come the Patriots, dribbling to the lane. It's great, out right wing. Three block, just Bolton, let it bounce right into the hands of Davis. Nicholas got the shot on, or got the hands on the shot, but Mason gets a layup out of it.
And that's just one of those unfortunate situations because everybody turns to look, and I mean, it was a great block, but just couldn't get the hands on the basketball.
And Abosi with it at the foul line, handing it to Cargo. Cargo working her way to the lane. Lefty floater wouldn't go. Weird looking shot, but it almost fell. And then Nicholas hustling for the rebound got fouled. She kept it alive. Davis was there, and I think she gave the contact for Mason. Only the third team foul on George Mason in the second quarter. So it'll be a possession for Delaware. Jardine returning for the Hens, as does Abby Gonzalez. To the bench, Erica Brown and Makeda Nicholas for UD.
Yeah, I like the aggressiveness there of Bailey Cargo with the footwork. She's got great footwork to be able to go left. She probably needed one more dribble there on the flick, but kind of got caught a little bit too far away from the basket.
Here's Gonzalez, wide open left wing triple, rattles around and out. Rebound on the weak side, grabbed by Bell, and then Anna Bosey fouls her, trying for the steal. Those are the kind of fouls she's got to avoid. It's two hustle plays that came late from Anna Bosey that led to whistle.
Yeah, when you're 90 feet from the basket, and I mean, she was trying to just get around her. She just ran into her. She wasn't trying to foul or even really trying to go for the ball, but you can't be committing those fouls 90 feet from the basket. She's too valuable to this team to be sitting on the bench in the final 3 minutes of the half.
Five straight from Mason, so a chance to try to tie or take the lead here. Final 2 3/4 minutes of this second quarter. On the drive, it's Williford Kelly, got it inside to Bell. Her shot was blocked. It's loose and out of bounds off the Hens, so it'll stay with Delaware. I think it took out Baby Blue over there, one of the Delaware mascots, but seems to be okay. Meanwhile, out of the game goes Bailey Cargo, returning Erica Brown for Delaware.
Yeah, Makeda Nicholas really fortunate there because she missed that rotation but was able to get the block from behind.
Length can make up for being a little late sometimes. Lob goes into right top of the key. Left wing goes to Kaminsky. On the baseline to Padgett. Opposite look. Nice catch by Kelly. Kelly with one to shoot, though didn't recognize. Floated at the buzzer. Wouldn't go. Chapman a rebound.
Great box out there by Sade Chapman.
Feeds it ahead to Gonzalez, running point across the timeline, top of the key, right wing bounce, feeding to Jardine, top of the circle, directing traffic, left wing bounce pass to Brown. Brown with 16 to shoot to Chapman, top of the key, lobbing inside, Nicholas, turnaround jumper is good. Boy, the Hens have that high post jumper down.
I'm loving what the post players are doing right now. They're patient, they're establishing position, and they're looking for the high-low.
26-22. Here's Wright the other way. She's been quiet, only 5 points in the early going. Had 25 the other night. Lobs it on the left block to Bell. Looks to the foul line. Padgett, 13-footer is good. Great ball movement from George Mason. Two-point game with 1:36 left in the half.
But that just cannot happen. You can't allow Tiffany Padgett to get that ball there. There were three Hens right in the lane, and no one bumped to the cutter.
It's good movement in the zone, though, from Mason, huh?
Yeah.
Chapman right wing, feeding to Gonzalez, into the corner to Jardine. Jardine looking for Chapman. Chapman right wing to Nicholas. Nicholas driving to the foul line, lobbing right black Chapman. Turnaround jumper, around and out. And a rebound grabbed by George Mason's right.
I also like how the post players are keeping the ball high when they are going to take that shot and face up to the basket. They're keeping the basketball high. They're not putting it on the ground for someone to take it.
60 seconds left in the half. Kaminsky near corner, driving towards the lane, lobbing it opposite rim to Kelly. Kelly to the foul line, lost it, but Pageant got it to Kaminsky. Left wing three is good, and Mason leads a 10-2 run, and it's 27-26 Patriots.
Kind of, you know. Again, this rotation is too slow on the three-point line. They're either getting caught too low or just not quick enough on the east-west rotation.
Hens really need a bucket here. 34 seconds left in the half. Jardine near corner, lobbing it on the block to Chapman, driving baseline into a double, lobbed it out to Brown. Brown, top of the key, Nicholas foot on the line, two. Line drive shot will go, long rebound. Jardine hustles for it. Both players hit the deck, and it's out of bounds off Mason. What an effort by Hannah Jardine to get Delaware the last possession of the half.
It would really be a shame if the Hens are not leading at the half, because they've outplayed George Mason pretty much in every aspect except rebounding. And to go into the half down one would not be indicative of what has happened in this first half.
Both teams had a use it or lose it timeout. So Delaware will take theirs. Three remaining now, 27-26, George Mason on top. 21 3/10 seconds left in the second quarter. Couple of things here. With that timeout, Mason coaching staff has that chance to remind their team if Delaware shoots too soon, they can take their use it or lose it timeout and advance the ball, which makes it even more important that Delaware really waits here. And offensively for the Hens, ball has really gotten a little stagnant of late. How do you get it moving again?
Well, I think they need to look to a step, I would say penetrate, but because they're doing a nice job in this inside-out game, I would look to pound it into the post right now. I think McKinney Nicholas is now out of the basketball game. So you're looking to get it inside, probably to shot a Chapman, but they have to take care of the basketball. The last thing they need is a turnover at this point coming out of the timeout. But really the name of the game right now is it's because of the rebounding and the lack of rebounding and rotation that they're in this position.
I'd like to see the ball come back out. It seems like they were reversing it out early.
I'm kind of surprised actually that Bailey Cargo isn't in the game just for her shooting ability for that inside out.
It's Gonzalez instead, Jardine, Brown, Chapman, and also Simone DeVries in there for Delaware. DeVries will throw it in. 21 3/10 seconds left in a half. Delaware down by a point. Entry pass goes to Gonzalez near the right wing. Dribbles towards the top of the key. 13 left in the half. Jardine, a two-man game with her. Sets the high screen. She dribbles towards the left wing. Spinning back. Looking for Brown. Can't find her. Bounce pass goes to Chapman at the foul line. Runner wouldn't go. Rebound loose. Grabbed by Mason. No timeout. They'll heave it. Well short. And that is the end for the opening half. George Mason 27. Delaware 26. Back and forth. But Patriots end the half on a 10-2 run.
And I really think George Mason missed an opportunity there. She got that basketball with about 3 seconds left, should have called timeout, would have advanced the basketball and had 3 seconds in the half court. Big mistake by George Mason, but you could tell that Delaware was looking, Abby Gonzalez was looking to free up Sade Chapman, and they waited too long, and then she took the shot too quickly. Sade Chapman had more time. She shot it with 6 seconds left to go. She could have made her move, taken her time, and let it go.
Instead, it is Mason leading by a point. We'll take time out. Come back with a Blue Hens halftime report presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. Comes your way in just a few moments with Ronnie Vickers back at our Newcastle studios. Delaware down one at the break. Back to those first half stats brought to you by RE/MAX, the individual leaders. They're balanced for Delaware offensively. Sade Chapman had 8, Makeda Nicholas 6, and 5 for Hannah Jardine. One player that got to get going. Erica Brown, only 2 points, only 3 shots over the first 20 minutes. Meanwhile, Mason was led by Tiffany Padgett, who had 9. They did a good job to Delaware on Kara Wright. She had just 5. Mason will go from left to right in the second half. We're underway in the third quarter. George Mason gets the ball to start things. Sarah Kaminsky, the freshman point guard, running things for George Mason. Out there as they start in the second half, Abby Gonzalez, she came off the bench early. Left wing, it's right with it for George Mason. Up top, her feed goes to Bolton. Bolton in the corner, open three. Kaminsky hits over Anabosi, and it's a 4-point lead for George Mason.
And that was on that back line rotation. Again, sinking in too low. When there's a corner player, you can't sink in that low. You have to stay in between.
Is Brown the other direction for Delaware. Feeding it top of the circle. Gonzalez dribbling to the right wing. Backing up in front of the Delaware bench. Bounce pass top of the key. Anabosi. Anabosi calling for Brown to come get the ball. She does. Brown driving to the foul line. Out to Gonzalez. Back to Anabosi. 10 to shoot with it. Top of the key. Anabosi being played off of. Hands it off to Gonzalez. 5 to shoot. She's going to have to make something happen off the dribble. Inside to Chapman. Turnaround jumper at the buzzer. Off the mark. Not a great possession there for Delaware. Rebound, Jason Bolton.
Not a great possession, but they got the shot they wanted. She just didn't take her time there. I think she rushed it thinking the shot clock was lower than it was.
A little moving pick, no call. They lob it inside to Wright. Wright looks opposite to Bell. Great touch feed to Padgett. Lays it home. George Mason up 6. And not as clean defensively to start the second half for UD.
No, and halftime's all about adjustments. And this back line right now is killing Delaware on those first two possessions. They're just not rotating.
Gonzalez has it left wing, picks up her bounce. Bounce pass goes top of the key to Brown. Brown dribbling right wing, attacking towards the lane. Out to Anabosi to continue to play off her. She drives to the foul line and walks as she picked up her bounce. And Nicole Anabosi. Right now, George Mason daring her to shoot the jumper that she's worked on all summer, but seems to be shying away from a little bit. She'll take a seat, replaced by Hannah Jardine.
Yeah, and right away, you see Tina Martin going to her senior, one of her senior leaders, Hannah Jardine, hoping to calm this team down and get something going offensively.
She balances the floor a little bit on the offensive end, too.
Well, and she is a guard forward, so she's kind of that in-between player. She's that swing player, and her rotation on the back line is usually pretty good.
Right wing give to Bolton. Bolton lobs it inside to Bell. Turn and face opposite. Look tall feed. Wright had to leave her feet to get it. Feeding top of the key. Bolton head fake did not get the defender in the air to Kaminsky. Deep three, way off the mark. Bolton the rebound. Follow shot good. And it is an 8-point lead. And back to the first half, it is now a 17-2 George Mason run.
Yeah, and again, it's the same things plaguing. They're not putting a body on somebody. But on that defensive end also, you see Hannah Jardine talking. She's telling those young players where to go.
Brown dribbling to the foul line, now right of the lane, spinning out, lobbing it, far wing Jardine inside. Nicholas turnaround jumper around and out. Padgett the rebound for George Mason.
And there's no one on the weak side on that back line either to crash the offensive boards.
Kaminsky lobbing it inside. Bell got doubled out to Padgett, straightaway triple, front rim no, rebound loose, Nicholas grabbed it, a foul caught on Bell for George Mason, who pounds the hardwood in frustration. Just wanted to make sure she wasn't hurt, it was just frustration, and she's helped to her feet, and that'll be the first team foul, second on Chianyiri Bell.
And Delaware really lucky there. Abby Gonzalez sunk really low, going after the rebound, and was very late on that shot, but they missed it, and they were able to get that rebound. As those guards cannot sink to the block. You can sink a little bit, but you can't sink that far down.
So Gonzalez will bring it up for Delaware. Hens got to do something for the perimeter right now. They're struggling with the inside game, at least just to make them guard it on the outside, you'd think. Brown needs to get going. She has it right wing. Handing it off to Jardine. Bounce pass, four corner goes to Brown. Brown a jab step, lobbing it inside to Nicholas. Backing down the defender, spinning and banks it too strong. Rebound tapped out of bounds by Jardine. And back to George Mason it goes. Although that was a good look for Makeda Nicholas.
It is a very good look. She's just got to be a little careful from fading away on every shot. Some of them, it's fine, but you got to lean and try to draw that foul on that shot. Go to the basket, square up, and go lean into the basket.
Hens have not scored 3 minutes into the third quarter. Mason is scoring. Baseline drive right. Reverse layup is good. double-digit lead for Mason, their largest of the game.
There's no way that they should allow Kara Wright to do what she just did on that back line. There should be someone there. There's no way you should allow a reverse layup in that matchup zone.
Brown to the foul line, picked up her bounce, got the defender in the air, angle jumper wouldn't go, rebound in and out of her hands, and Kaminsky has it. Cannot get Erica Brown going. Kaminsky racing it forward. Brown pawed at her, couldn't get it. Instead, drives to the lane, draws the defense, lays it to Wright, who puts it home. It's 38-26. George Mason, a 21-2 run spanning two halves for George Mason, and Hens have to take a timeout. We'll take it with Delaware, 6:26 left in the third quarter. Mason up a dozen. You're listening to Delaware Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410.
Win the next minute 26 and get to that media timeout, but win this quarter from here on and try to chip away at this lead.
Here comes Delaware offensively. They lob it inside to Anabosi. Double comes on the left block. She was fouled, couldn't get the shot to go, but she'll head to the stripe to shoot two. Good aggressive tape from Anabosi.
And you love when they come out of a timeout and they execute the play that the coaches draw. You could tell they were bringing it to the left side, trying to feed it into Anabosi, and she took her time, got the shot off, just didn't finish.
Anabosi lived at the line a year ago. Team high 144 free throws. Her first of this season is good. She improved as the season went on, knocking down foul shots relatively consistently over the second half of the season. One more for Anabosi, the sophomore out of Gaithersburg, Maryland. And a free throw is good. And so it's back to a 10-point game. And Hens will go with some three-quarter court pressure.
And that's all you need. Just need to chip away a little bit, but they got to still do the same thing. Pound the basketball in.
Entry fee goes to Pageant as they work past the pressure, but the high-low feed results in a walk as they dished it opposite block to Dodson, who bobbled it, dragged the pivot, and back to Delaware it goes.
And you can see Tina Martin trying to catch George Mason off guard, throwing a little bit of a mix here in the half court. Great rotation there by Anabosi.
By the way, you are a fantastic multitasker. Broadcasting the game and mothering at the same time. Brown driving towards the lane, and a foul called on Mason on the hand check on her way to the basket as Brown got bumped. And it'll be Delaware ball as a foul came on the floor.
Yeah, maybe a little motto, maybe came over asking if they could go get popcorn with their friend, and yes, I said yes.
What good kids did they come over to ask for permission no matter what?
Well, they know I know where they are in the arena, that's why.
Jardine, far sideline, inbound pass. Remember, mom is always watching. Inbound goes to Gonzalez out there center court, dribbling towards the left wing, angling towards the lane, back out to the corner, picks up her bounce. Bounce pass goes left elbow to Anabosi, back out to Gonzalez, her three off the mark, rebound tipped around, and finally corralled by Padgett. Padgett on the run the other way. Two on two in the open floor. Pull-up jumper wouldn't go. Anabosi the rebound. Delaware wants to run. Anabosi feeds it forward to Chapman. Lost it on the bounce. And now Anabosi gets it back. Stole away from her own teammate. Feeds it out far corner to Brown, who spins it and slows it up.
Great job by Anabosi to get that ball out. And Chapman trying to go before she had it. But luckily for the Hens, Anabosi got it back.
Entry feed, Anabosi plus the foul as she got it center of the lane. Lefty finish, Hens back to within eight.
And this is a great recipe for Hens success right here. Pound the ball into Nicole Anabosi. She's starting to get in a rhythm, and this is when you're a young guard, you got to recognize that and keep feeding her. Keep feeding who's hot.
Timeout, George Mason. So back and forth we go. We'll take it with the Patriots. 5:11 left in the third quarter. It's George Mason, 38. Delaware 30. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOB. Stepped up of late.
Of late, yeah, absolutely. And I think that, again, the Hens need to keep going to her and give her an opportunity to draw some fouls, get some easy buckets.
Misses the free throw, however, so the lead stays at eight for George Mason, 38-30. She was at the line after got fouled, trying for the old-fashioned three-point play before the timeout. Wright hoists the three the other direction, wouldn't go. Anabosi the rebound, one and done for George Mason.
And that's, again, that's all Delaware needs to do, one and done.
Gonzalez across the timeline to the left wing. Entry feed, left block goes to Chapman. Lobs it top of the circle to Brown. Right to the lane. Lefty layup wouldn't go, but she was fouled. Boy, did she try as she got bumped twice on her way to the 10 and heads to the stripe for a pair.
And this is a place where Delaware now can start chipping away again. They're only shooting 57% right now from the free throw line. So they really need to make those free throws.
Brown. Line left, senior from Patterson, New Jersey. Knocked down 70, or 106 tries a season ago. bends the knees, releases the basketball, and rattles it home. So back within seven. Remember, it was a 21-2 run, but since then, Delaware's answered with five straight of their own, looking for six with Brown at the line for one more. Takes her time and can't hit. Back rim no good. Rebound Bell, had it knocked free by Chapman, got it back, but then threw it away. Out of bounds, back to Delaware.
And that's George Mason's seventh turnover. Really up to this point, they have taken pretty good care of the basketball. Really both teams have. But you can't make that mistake here, and Delaware needs to capitalize on this extra possession.
Gonzalez dribbling it across the timeline, bounce pass right wing to Jardine, hands it there to Brown. Brown dribbling towards the top of the key, high screen from Anabosi. Into the corner, Jardine, head fake to three, steps into a deep two, front rimmed it. Anabosi tipped the rebound to Chapman, layup good! From the left block, it's 38-33, seven straight for Delaware.
Defense creates offense. They get the turnover and then they capitalize.
Three-quarter court pressure here from the Hens. And a foul on Gonzalez as they threw it over the top. She bumped into J.C. Bolton, but how about Shadi Chapman inside, just the quick release?
Yeah, she's doing a great job keeping that ball high, squaring up to the basket. And I think if she keeps doing that, she's going to be one of the go-to people down low for the Hens.
4:08 left third quarter. George Mason leading 38-33. We're going to talk about it. A game of runs. This has certainly been that. On the drive, Sylvia Maxwell into contact. Foul came on the floor. It was from Abby Gonzalez. Gonzalez had just picked up her second foul, and now she has her third, team second in this third quarter.
Yeah, and that's one of those plays you got. You got to keep your hands off. You got to beat her to the spot. And like you said, she picked up 2 fouls in about 10 seconds.
Not seeing much of Bailey Cargo here in this second half. Maxwell on the inbound, called for the walk. Had it on the baseline, showed the ball to the defender, but moved her feet before she put it on the deck.
Delaware's pressure really starting to get to George Mason in these last couple minutes, forcing a couple turnovers here.
Here is Cargo on cue into the game, and to the bench goes Abby Gonzalez. Meanwhile, Maxwell checks out for George Mason. She is replaced by teammate Kara Wright. Brown will run point here for Delaware across the timeline. Bounce pass to Anabosi. Wasn't looking, and it's ripped away from her by Pageant. Tie up. Arrow keeps it with Delaware, but a completely unforced error there from the Hens.
Yeah, I'm not even sure what happened. It looked like Nicole Anabosi was looking down or trying to establish position or something, and Erica just kind of nonchalantly passed it to her, and it seemed like both players weren't expecting that.
Maybe she was looking. It was Tina Martin talking to Anabosi. Was she peeking over to the bench, it looked like? Certainly not towards Brown. Here's the inbound to Jardine, far corner, up top to Erica, around the perimeter, near wing. The feed goes to Cargo. Cargo up top to Chapman. Lobs it inside Anabosi. Lefty bank. Good and one. Nicole Anabosi taking over the third quarter. 3:31 to go. Delaware back to within three.
What a great job by Nicole Anabosi to lean in and draw that contact. She switches the ball to her left hand and leans in with her right shoulder, but she stayed square to the basket. Didn't absorb the contact and hope to get foul and throw it up. She absorbed the contact, stayed focused, stayed squared, and laid it in.
What a wild third quarter. Hens didn't score for the first 4 minutes. Mason hasn't scored since then. Anabosi's free throw is good. It's 10 straight for Delaware, and they're back to within two.
And this three-quarter court pressure has really helped the Hens right now. They're doing a good job with the rover spot, getting back into the middle and not allowing that middle entry.
Give up an open three to Pageant. She swishes it over Jardine, and that ends the 10-0 run. It's 41-36.
And that's one of the things when you're trying then to get back into your half-court set on defense, you have to rotate out.
Brown flaring to the near wing, picks up her bounce, feeds to Cargo, way outside the arc, between the rings, dribbles towards the right wing, into the lane, got fouled on her way up, and will head to the stripe. Didn't look like a freshman there. Aggressive move from the 5'10 freshman out of Greensboro, North Carolina.
And it seems like George Mason thought they had the ball, that they were, they wanted a jump ball there. They thought they had their hands equally on the ball, but I like the aggressiveness there and the decision-making for Bailey Cargo as she kind of looked away. As she was going down the lane, she looked off like she was going to pass it to the corner and then try to lay it up.
First free throw is good. One more coming line left. That one around it in. And it's 41-38, Delaware to within three.
And that's that game knowledge that Janine Reese talked about. It's the little things, you look off, a fake pass, little things that get the defender moving.
She tipped the pass, but it went into the hands of Padgett. Padgett finds right out near center court. Hands it left wing to Kaminsky. Lobs it opposite wing to Padgett. She threw it to no one. Great hustle by Wright to run it down in front of her own bench. Into the corner, Kaminsky. Cross court feed to Padgett on the right wing. Six to shoot. Drives baseline. Step back jumper over Chapman. Front rim, no. And a Bosey tipped the rebound to Brown. Brown on the run. Two on two with a teammate. Chapman with her. Brown goes all the way. Banks it in. Hens within one.
Great job by Erica Brown to go around the defender, avoiding the charge. She didn't want to take the short pull-up, but she kind of maneuvered her body around to not draw contact.
Defender took the teammate away, and Brown took the basket. Kaminsky near center court, 2:06 to go, third quarter. Near wing, Bolton with it. Bolton driving to the baseline. Bobbled it, lost it, out of bounds. Help came from Chapman, and it forced the turnover. Delaware a chance to go back in front.
And just the defensive presence right now for Delaware, you know, it's been about four turnovers in the last 4 minutes for George Mason.
Shoving in for George Mason, they're going deep to the bench. Jewel Triggs will play for the first time as she replaces the freshman Bolton. And right now, Adam Millison just looking for something to work. Brown across the timeline for Delaware, dribbling to the top of the key. Cross-court feed right wing to Chapman. Hands it there to Jardine. 1:47 left of the quarter. Entry feed on the right baseline. Chapman jumper good. Delaware back up one.
A little smirk there from Sade Chapman. She wanted that basketball. She wanted to take that shot.
A 16-3 run for UD. And all of a sudden, we seesaw back and forth. Delaware's in front. Padgett thought about a straightaway triple. Feeds it into the corner. Not a threat to shoot was Triggs. Triggs, cross-court feed to Wright. Wright drives to the lane, forces one up. Wouldn't go, but she was fouled, and she'll head to the line for two.
Good job there rotating. That was just a great athletic move there by George Mason. And another great move was by Dave Arthur, your good friend, bringing you out some water here from the back room.
He might be the best friend I have in the world right now. Two free throws coming line right for Wright. 5'11", fifth-year senior out of Louisville, Kentucky. As I try to keep any voice whatsoever, first free throw rattles home. She had 25 in that win over Radford. She had 18 last year against Delaware. She was a consistent scorer, the transfer out of Southeast Missouri State. She led the team in points per game. She also averaged almost 3 assists per game.
Not only did she have 25 points, but she was 9-for-12 from field goal.
She hits the second free throw here, and it's Mason back up by a point, 43-42, 1:15 left for the clock.
This is a really good early test for these Hens to be in this situation where it's going back and forth.
Here's Nicholas near corner to... It was Daly Cargo who got blocked on her way to the basket. We were shielded off by the official, I beg your pardon. But the freshman not showing any fear, going right amongst the trees.
Not at all. And once McKenna Nicholas stepped off, she could have just dumped it right back to her for a short corner shot.
Lob the inbound out near center court to Brown. Brown gives it top of the key to Anabosi. 10 on the timer. Right wing lob over to Brown. Brown left hand bounce to the top of the key. 5 to shoot. Got it to Cargo. Into the corner, Jardine. Entry feed, Nicholas. Turnaround jumper rattles home. Delaware back up one. 43 seconds left in the third quarter.
What great patience. What great ball movement. Everybody touched the basketball, and McKenna Nicholas taking her time on the turnaround with 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
Well, I like Kaminsky's poise for a freshman. Lobbed it over the top of the pressure and then went right back to her teammate to get the ball. See if they can get some offense started. They've been staggered here late in this third quarter. Triggs dribbling top of the key. 8 to shoot. Left wing right into the corner. Padgett over Nicholas. 3 wouldn't go. Great box out by Brown. She was fouled. Triggs trying to pull Brown away. Mason's over the limit. Erica Brown will walk the length and shoot two.
Yeah, and these Hens are really kind of coming together here in the last few minutes of this quarter. Remember, at 6:26, we said you just want to win the next 6 minutes and 26 seconds, and the Hens have done that. And not only have they won, they've dominated, and they've taken now the lead. They haven't just chipped away. They've taken the lead.
Brown, 2 free throws, line left, really taking her time this year. Much more deliberate approach to the line. It works with a swish here. So the lead up to 2, 45-43. Boy, they are just shoving bodies in and out left and right. Now it'll be Deja Williford Kelly back in for the first time, second half for Mason. Also returning is J.C. Bolton. To the bench goes Triggs and Dotson for George Mason. Just trying to find anything to stem the bleeding right now. One more foul shot coming for Brown. Deep breath as she takes her time. Bends the knees, releases a high arcer that goes. And it's 46-43.
You know, we talked about it being an advantage for George Mason of playing that, played that game on Friday night. But they may be a little tired, too, having a road trip and playing two games in 1.5 days, really.
Good point. 5 seconds left in the quarter. Trying to get a shot off. Bolton drove into traffic, threw it away. Steele Nicholas, end of the quarter. What a run by the Hens to close out the third period as they go on a 23-5 spurt and they lead 46-43 at the end of the third quarter. We'll take a break, come back with a fourth. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Send it to overtime. Let's go, Hens.
Scoreless at the half, down 2-0, and now in OT. Ralph Founder Kirkhoff's team just continues to amaze. By the way, Abby Gonzalez back with the athletic training staff, getting her back worked on as we start playing the fourth quarter. A walk against George Mason. Deja Williford Kelly on a little UCLA high post look, bobbled the ball, and took 2 steps before she put it on the deck.
Yeah, Delaware's defense really the reason right now why they are now leading this game. And defense turns into offense. They're getting some momentum. They're getting those stops, not allowing those extra possessions, causing turnovers, and then capitalizing on the offensive end.
9:42 to go, fourth quarter, and Abosi lost it as she tried to dribble it in front of the defender. Give her credit. She stuck with it, hit the deck, and caused the tie-up. That'll keep possession with the Hens, but kind of an unforced error there to lose the arrow.
Yeah, that's unfortunate because especially in women's basketball, there tends to be, you know, jump balls at unique times in the game, especially at the end of the basketball game, so you always want to have that arrow in your favor.
Good news. Gonzalez returning to the bench for Delaware. She seems all right. The inbound goes from the other freshman, Cargo, into the corner to Brown. 15 on the timer. She circles out towards the top of the key. Got a high screen from Nicholas. Cross-court feed to Cargo. Cargo looking for Anabosi instead to Brown. 7 to shoot. Drives the lane. Out to Nicholas. Right elbow jumper. No good. Weak side rebound grabbed by Chinyeri Bell.
And I think there was a hand on that ball, why it came off so flat. But it was a good 1-2 stepping up. She's got to get that ball up a little higher.
Here's right the other direction for Mason. Down by three, almost a minute into this fourth quarter. Holding the ball, surveying her options. Bounce pass left wing, goes to Kaminsky. Back to right, and an arm bar call against Delaware. Man, Bailey Cargo called for the personal. And here's what we saw repeatedly last year. Call the game one way all night, and then switch in the final quarter.
Yeah, I just don't understand that. We haven't seen, there's been hands all over the place and no one's been called. Actually, the arm bar is what you're allowed to do. You're not allowed to have the open hand, but you can have an arm bar.
It's way more fun without all the whistles, I'll say that much.
Yeah.
Inbound to Kaminsky, offensive foul. That one was more fun, that whistle. Jerry Bell pushing off on Makeda Nicholas. And the makeup call goes Delaware's way.
Well, you know, like Jerry Seinfeld says, things always seem to even out for him. So maybe things are evening out here.
Hens even, Steven in that exchange, but they lead by three on the scoreboard. Here's Brown near quarter, feeding top of the circle to Anabosi, dribbling right wing, handing there to Jardine. Bounce pass far corner, Nicholas lobs it inside, Anabosi, righty power wouldn't go, got her own miss, backed it home. Anabosi showing persistence that pays off, Hens up five.
And definitely a crowd favorite here. Nicole Anabosi has won this crowd over last year with her grit, with her tenacity, and with her never give up attitude.
Now a throwaway, Jardine stole it from right. Two on one, running with a left hand, stopping at the block, kicking it out to Cargo, who hits the jumper. Barely Cargo running the floor, Hens up seven. Timeout, George Mason, and a Hens crowd comes to its feet. Delaware playing well, will take the timeout with the Patriots. 8:03 left in the fourth. Delaware leading 50-43 on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. Going to the Final Four. They just made the announcement on the loudspeaker here at the Bob, and that brings the crowd alive as well. So congratulations. Rolf Vander Kerkhoff's team is headed to the Final Four. What an accomplishment.
Unbelievable. And what a great group of young women, that team. The four CAA championships in a row. Now the Final Four beating the number one overall team in Duke. Fantastic job. Congratulations, Delaware Field Hockey and Rolf.
Absolutely incredible. High pass. Mason turns it over back to Delaware. What a time to be a Blue Hen.
I'll tell you what, some great things going on. The men's soccer team is also playing in the CAA championship. And you know, like you said, men's basketball, volleyball, doing some great things. I'll tell you what a great weekend for Blue Hen sports.
Volleyball's won 7 of their last 8 matches. And they've clinched the CAA tournament berth as well. Hens looking for a win here. Jardine with it. Hens leading by 7. 7:28 to go, fourth quarter. High post entry to Anabosi. 15-footer hit flat off the back of the rim and fell through. Delaware up a game high 9.
Just a fantastic job. It really coming alive here in the third and fourth quarter, the second half in general.
There's right, left wing, cross-court feed, take it away. Chapman jumped it, stole it. Delaware ball, 7:07 to go, up by 9. First time that Delaware's reached the national semifinals since the lacrosse team for the field hockey group is Chapman's 15-footer, would not go. And a rebound corralled by Kara Wright.
Yeah, you're talking about 2007 with Alex Smith as a face-off specialist, led the NCAA, and now field hockey going to the Final Four. Fantastic.
Reach side rebound, corralled on the missed jumper. J.C. Bolton lays it home. It's back to a 7-point game. I guess my other job might be offended as a foul called against George Mason. Bailey Cargo drawing the personal. Hens, of course, on football got for the national semifinals, national championship game in 2010. So second time since 2010 that the Hens have been able to get there. But an incredible accomplishment. Speaking of accomplishments, this basketball team, what a gritty effort here as they lead by 7 with the ball and showing some patience, good leadership from the freshman. Yeah. Jardine has it far corner. No patience there. Hits the 3. Double-digit lead for Delaware.
I'll tell you what, Hannah Jardine has made a huge impact here in the second half. Both, you know, running that back line, making some great passes, getting some shots off, and really good-looking stroke there.
Hens tipped the pass, but it ends up in the hands of Bolton, and she was fouled as she went up with a shot from Anabosi. But boy, Hannah Jardine was asking for that ball, ready to catch and shoot. Good feed from the freshman Cargo, but what a pretty looking shot.
Yeah, and we're going to see a lot of that this year. Is Bailey Cargo, Abby Gonzalez, Erica Brown hitting those shoots. There's more options. There's more weapons behind that three-point arc.
First free throw is good for Bolton. So the lead is down to 9, 55-46. 6:13 remaining here in the fourth quarter. One more free throw. Bolton, the freshman out of Drexel, Missouri. Line right, second foul shot good. By the way, speaking of Drexel, what a win for them the other day.
Unbelievable. They beat Penn State by 23 at Drexel. And just a fantastic job. 30 points by
Rachel Pellecchio.
Yeah, fantastic.
It was Chapman on the left block. Got it with 16 to shoot, trying to back down the defender. Turnaround jumper, rattled in and out. Rebound corralled by Bolton for George Mason. They want to push the other way. Still time, down by 8, 5:50 to go. Bolton at the foul line, push shot wouldn't go. And Abosi and Chapman get the rebound. And Brown gets the outlet pass, spins it forward the other direction. 2-on-2, racing away to the bucket. Righty finish wouldn't go. Chapman the rebound, she's fouled. And he'll head to the stripe to shoot 2. And the hustle from Delaware there as the bigs crashed the glass and then turned and ran the floor, and that's what set that up.
It's just a huge difference here in the second half with the way the Hens are pounding the glass. They aren't just turning around, boxing. They are going after the basketball, all costs necessary, diving on the floor, and that needs to be the identity of this team.
So a chance to get it back to double digits if Chapman can convert at the free throw line. She'll shoot 2, 56% season to go. It's the first three. Brown got bumped but didn't get the call, but it was Chapman running the floor with Cargo, and there just weren't enough bodies in there to box out for George Mason. One more free throw. Chapman can't make it a double-digit lead. Did she get her own miss back? Almost did, but had it knocked free from her, and she fell down. So now a 4-on-3 if they hurry. They lob it inside of the right block. Dodson spinning into Jardine, and she was fouled. Jardine thought she went straight up, but it's going to be 2 free throws.
And Hannah Jardine, you know, I kind of agree with the sentiment going on in the arena right now. She had her feet planted before the ball was even, you know, fed in there, and she stayed straight up. I don't know what else you're supposed to do if you're Hannah Jardine.
Officials seem to give the indication that it was the lower body trying to bump her off the spot. I didn't see that, though, either.
I mean, that's how you're taught to play defense on the block. And, you know, again, you can't make that call. I don't know what a defender's supposed to do.
First free throw, though, no good. What do they say? Ball don't lie. 5:28 left. Hens leading by 9. One more foul shot coming for Dotson. Can't hit, but rebound grab by Bell. Her foul blocked by Chapman. Anabosi saved it on her own basket, but to a teammate. Jardine doubled at it, stripped free. Layup wouldn't go for Dotson. Whistle and a foul on Delaware. Wild exchange there under the basket. Turnovers, fouls, missed layups, and it'll stay with George Mason.
Yeah, and tough go there for Hannah Jardine, picking up 2 fouls in like the last 20 seconds there. Just trying to get the basketball, and now she's most likely to come out of the game, and she's done a lot of great things here in this quarter.
I think the crowd's a little displeased by that call. Out of the game goes Jardine. You're right, Nicholas replaces her. Line right inbound comes from Mason. It goes to Bell, splits a double, kicks it out. Dotson for 3, wouldn't go. Box out and rebound for Chapman.
Fantastic there again. Shade Chapman going to the basketball, going up for it while sealing at the same time. Just a great job.
Brown across the timeline for Delaware. 5 minutes left on the clock. Hens leading by 9, and Brown got fouled. Double came as they tried to hedge the high screen. And a foul called on Dotson for George Mason. Actually, they give it to Great. It'll be her first, team's 4th. So the Hens will shoot every foul the rest of the way.
And, you know, Delaware is still getting out-rebounded by George Mason, 32-24. But it just seems like lately every rebound is their ball.
Inbound will come from Nicholas near sideline. Makeda looking to get it in. Saw Anabosi. Instead goes to Brown out near midcourt. Brown dribbling to the left wing. High screen from Anabosi towards the top of the key. Picked up for bounce. Got the defender in the air. Lobs it far corner. Cargo. Cargo dribbles in front of her own bench. Hands it to Anabosi. Foul line right. Head fake. Driving towards the baseline. Double comes to Chapman. Extra feed. Cargo 3. Got it. Oh, Bailey. Cargo was ready and hit Delaware by a dozen.
Tell you what, I just love her demeanor on the floor as well. She is just stone cold, man. She got ice water in her veins. She does not change her expression no matter what's going on. What a great shot.
Shooters will shoot, and she hit it. Foul the other way as Wright tried to attack. Caught against the Hens. It'll be 2 free throws coming as a result for Kara Wright. Louisville, Kentucky native. They called the foul on Cargo, her 2nd. Both teams now over the limit.
I think Bailey Cargo has won over some fans here and is gaining some early support in her freshman campaign as one of the favorites here. When they say Bailey Cargo for 3, as Kevin Peelan does quite often.
Voice of the Bob Carpenter Center. One more free throw as the first one went, 59-48. And Wright can't hit it. Her first missed foul shot of the season as a rebound corralled by Brown for Delaware.
Now, Delaware, what they need to do is run their offensive sets. You're going to see them not rushing their shots. They're going to use the shot clock, but you don't want to get stagnant. Again, you still have to attack.
Inside to Chapman. They look opposite wing. Nicholas, her jumper, back rim, no. Good rebound from Bell on the weak side.
And I don't think that's the shot that Tina Martin wanted for this basketball team, as she kind of let Makeda Nicholas hear it on her way down. I think they wanted to get that ball inside.
Came with about 15 or 16 still left for the shot clock. Good defense, though, as Nicholas tried to make up for it. Cut off the baseline. Knocked it out of bounds. It'll stay with Mason. 18 to shoot. 3:58 to go. Delaware up 11.
You know, with a young team, too, you want to make sure you're not you don't want to play not to lose. You want to still play to win and attack, but you don't want to take too much air out of the ball.
It is a fine line as Kaminsky for 3 for the left wing. Wide open, flat shot, back rim, no good. Rebound, Nicholas. No rotation on that look from Kaminsky whatsoever. Brown has it across the timeline for Delaware. Now up 11. Clock is there, friend. 3:35 to go, especially when the ball's in Brown's hands. Feeds it. Foul line right to Nicholas. Nicholas driving the lane. Picked up her bounce out to Anabosi. Deep 2. Good. 17-footer. Nicole Anabosi's got 13. Delaware up a baker's dozen.
And that's something where she's really improved, is that 14, 15-foot jump shot.
Out to Padgett. Her jumper from the right block wouldn't go. Cargo diving to the floor. Couldn't get the rebound, but at least tipped it out of bounds.
Yeah, and I like the way Nicole Anabosi, after she made that shot, she let her arm hang there a little bit. I like that, making sure it went in. She was posing for the camera.
you can pose when you have this kind of second half is inside on the entry. Bell got it, got fouled by Chapman on the up and under move. And he'll head to the stripe for a pair.
Yeah, that's one of those plays where you kind of give them the open door there and you try to block from behind. And coach's not real happy with that because they want her to face up, keep your hands up. You don't want to give them free points with 3:08 to go.
Peter Martin and Janine Ruiz calling Erica Brown over for a quick word. Free throw no good from Tenieri Bell. She has not made a free throw all season. Granted, it's only game number two, but Dillon with an over and can't afford that with her team down by 13, 3:08 left on the clock.
And if you're Erica Brown, too, you're letting your team know we have two timeouts. You know, she's pulling them in, say, hey, guys, we have two timeouts. You know, if we get into trouble, you can call one with 3 minutes to go. So that's really a benefit for this team going down the stretch if they get into trouble.
Mason down to one timeout remaining. Bell did hit the second free throw, so she's finally got one this season. But Delaware is still up by 12, 3:07 and ticking. Inbound to Cargo. Cargo back pass to Brown. Double comes at three-quarter court. Cargo gets it back from Brown across the timeline, lobbing it forward to Chapman, finding Brown calm near center court.
Yeah, that was a very nice shot, breaking that pressure there by all involved.
Brown bounce pass, left wing to Chapman. Back to Brown, opposite wing. Driving right of the lane, kicking it out to Nicholas. Nicholas lobbing it inside. Anna Bosey got some space on the defender, got the angle, and got fouled as she went up. Well, ahead of a stripe to shoot two, and that is a big difference, at least in my mind, this year from last, leaning in without picking up the charge to draw a little space.
You're absolutely right, because that was, because she's so aggressive, she would get called for that cutoff, but what she did there was she regrouped. She kind of didn't have total control of the ball, and instead of going up with it, falling a little bit out of control, she went up strong and regrouped.
First free throw is good. One more coming for Delaware. They lead by 13. With 2:41 to go here in this fourth quarter. One more foul shot coming. Line left, Anna Bosey's got 15 as she rattles home the second. 63-49 Delaware. They did have a man cherry-picking back to Nathan, and they beat him up the floor right late at home. Delaware fell asleep back to a 12-point game.
And again, if you're Delaware, you're taking your time, you're breaking the pressure, knowing that you have two timeouts, getting into your half-court set, and using your entire shot clock. But pound that ball inside.
Brown out near center court, dribbling the left wing, spinning towards the center of the floor, looking for some help, finds Cargo, lob entry to Chapman. Chapman backing down the defender, spins away from the double and floats it home. 65-51.
Sade Chapman and Makeda Nicholas this year taking their time on their post moves, not rushing the shot once they face up to the basket, and that's been all the difference.
On a drive here by Crate through a double but couldn't finish with a righty runner, and Nicholas the flat-footed rebound, and now the Hens can sense it. 1:45 on the clock and up by 14 with possession.
Yeah, really just impressed with the adjustments they made at halftime, the way they responded. You know, and it says a lot when a team can respond in that way. Not only did they respond, we said they dominated that third quarter going on that 23-5 run.
I mean, incredible stuff from down 38-26 to up 14 as Cargo threw it inside, had it tipped away, but they ran the whole shot clock right the other direction, racing into the front court. Delaware back defensively, forces a tough baseline driving, and a Bosey stopped her at the rim, then tipped it forward, racing the other way, and misses the layup. Nicholas, though, tipped the rebound and got fouled. Bodies down in a heap. Oh, man, did Anna Bosey break out the other direction. Everybody up and all right. Get the hand from the crowd. 1:06 to go. Two free throws for Makeda Nicholas.
Do you remember early in the third quarter when I said there is no way that Kara Wright should be able to shoot a reverse layup on the backside of that zone? Well, they adjusted that, too, because Nicole Anna Bosey just stuffed it right back at her and recovered her for the last time in the third quarter when she did the same exact thing.
Nicholas shoots the first free throw. One more coming. She's got 9. She makes this. Only 4 hands in double figures, including 3 bigs. Oh. Ellie Cargo's got blood on her hand. Tina Martin coaches everything, explaining to the freshmen that if you have blood on your hand, you don't touch your uniform because then it can get on the uniform and you can't stay in the game. And now Tina Martin going to help her wipe it off the leg, the blood, to try to make sure that they're able to stay in the ball game.
Yep, Tina Martin, head coach and athletic trainer as well.
She
He can do a little bit of everything. Good job by the athletic training staff to keep her in the game. And she gets a round of applause from the crowd here. New athletic trainer this year, Melanie Johnson, for the Hens. And a second free throw, good, 67-51, 1:03 left on the clock. Driving the other direction, forcing one up was great. It was blocked again. Goes out of bounds, it'll stay with Neeson, 1:01 left to go.
And Nicole and Abou, I tell you what, that back line, Nicole and Abou, Chapman, Nicholas, blocking a lot of shots this game.
Cross-court feed, Kaminsky, right wing triple, front rim, no. Chapman the rebound for Delaware, and the Hens are going to win the opener and win it in pretty impressive fashion. From 12 down in the second half, they outscore George Mason by 28 over the final 15 minutes. 38 seconds left on the clock. They lead 67-51. Brown driving to the lane, floats it up, can't get it to go. Rebound tip grab by Wright, 27 seconds to go. One more shot here, it's Wright driving to the foul line. Backing up top of the key, Kaminsky in the corner. Back to right is Delaware putting the finishing touches on this win. Crate left wing triple, no good. Rebound Kaminsky, blocked by Chapman, and a fitting finish for Delaware. Bob Carpenter Center crowd rises to its feet. Hens outscore Mason by 28 in the game's final 15 minutes and win the opener 67-51.
Wow. What a range of emotions. Early in that third quarter, you know, you're sitting here thinking, oh my goodness, like this could get bad quickly. And we said what a dangerous stretch they were in when they were down by 12. And what a turnaround. Now you look at the score and across the CAA, they're going to see the score and be like, wow, Delaware handled George Mason. Not so much, but they responded to George Mason in this one second half by the Delaware Blue Hens.
Sure did handle them over the final 15 minutes. A dominant stretch of basketball for Delaware as the Hens will celebrate at center court. A 67-51 win, and they put four players in double figures, and Erica Brown isn't one of them. Impressive, to say the least, from UD. Anabosi and Chapman lead the way with 15 each. We'll take a break. Come back post-game show in a moment. The Hens win it by 16.